Yeah. What is it?
Three bank robbers futzed a job at the City First National. Right now they're holed up in a sporting club, the Red 55. That's between 5th and...
Yeah, I know where the Red 55 is. But it's not the kind of place I like to hang around in. Sorry, Captain.
Don't be an ass, Malone. They've got hostages.
All right, I'll be right there.
Be the chief. Quick. Hello? Yeah. Those three sons of bitches have already killed a hostage. What do you want me to do? Yes, sir. Right. Yeah, I've called in Malone. He's on his way over. Should be here in a minute or so. He's here now. He's moving.
Say they won't move until they've talked to one of us. You're elected. The chief says we have to negotiate. We have to accept all their conditions. Don't forget it. Robert, I don't want any other victims. A word to the wise, huh?
Keep your head down if you want it to stay on your neck. That's right. Keep calm. Visitors, don't move.
Keep an eye on them. I'll poke them. Okay, pay attention, cop. I'm only going to say this once. We want $2 million in unmarked used bills. Nothing smaller than 10s and nothing bigger than 50s. No consecutive serial numbers. We want a limo to take us to the airport and a plane to take us to Mexico. You boys behave yourself, and you'll get all these good folks back in one piece. Understand that, cop?
No way, pal.
Just great, Malone. You did it your way as usual. I gave you an order. You were sent in here to negotiate, weren't you? Accept all their demands. No more victims.
They're scum. Human garbage.
Don't.
It's a great steak, honey.
Well, a great windsurfer deserves no less. You going out again?
Mm-hmm. You know it.
I wish I were as attractive as 4.5 square feet of canvas. Really?
Well, you cook a better steak.
You will come back sometime, won't you?
Sooner or later.
Want to know what I think about that camper?
Should I try to guess, Hopkins? It's meant just for us.
You've broken it off with Alan, haven't you?
Stop right there. Don't move.
Elise, quit trying to change the subject.
Till, we have a job to do. Or do you think I should use these flashbulbs in an interrogation room?
I know he does it out of love, but...
Yeah.
I'm very fond of him, too. But right now, I need peace and quiet.
Only it doesn't work with him. You know, success didn't come overnight for me. I worked my tail off. And it's hard to stay on top. But I'll hold on. When another photographer is mentioned in a column, I know I still have a lot of fighting to do. I've got to concentrate on nothing but my job. I mean it. There's no hope. I suppose that's enough work for tonight. We'll finish this off tomorrow.
Aren't you leaving too, Elise?
No. I've got to get a few things ready for tomorrow.
Okay. So long.
So long. Jill, would you turn the light out as you leave, please?
Sure.
Hello.
Who's there? Who's that? Still you too?
Hi. Hope I didn't scare you.
Oh, you didn't scare me, Alan. But you gotta stop this power game. Don't you listen to the radio? The whole city is terrorized. All the things that are going on, and you play hide-and-seek at 11 p.m.
You're the one who's playing hide-and-seek with me. My sister's not very good at lying. She never was.
Just like you at keeping bargains.
I just came by to bring you this. You left it. And because I just can't go on without seeing you. The fault isn't mine. My God, I just can't get you out of my head.
Listen, Alan. Let's try to find a compromise. We'll talk often on the phone, all the time. But don't you go back on your word.
Sure. We always wind up doing what you want anyway.
Sight of blood bother you?
Forget that, goddammit! Get out here! She took pictures of me! We gotta find her and get them back! Move your asses!
Oh, what seems to be the matter,
They're murderers.
Lady?
They're trying to get me. They're murderers.
She took my picture. That bitch took shots.
She better be taken care of soon, I think.
You don't think. You don't do any thinking, none at all. You listen.
Do something, for God's sake. Arrest them or they'll kill me. Please help me, please.
All right, come on.
I hear you, Purvis. Time to eat. Red can again. Okay, you got it. Oh, shit. I'm in trouble. Okay, I hear you. Why couldn't I have a cat that was colorblind? We'll try the blue. Hey, Wheat, Purvis, I found one. I could eat it myself. This is something else, Purvis. Red label. Good, huh? Better eat it all, because if you don't, I will. Yeah, Malone.
Robert. You get your tail here in the office. I need to speak to you.
Okay. What is it this time?
Shut the door and come in.
I hope this is important. I left my cat at home, and he's alone. Well?
What we have tonight is another murder, but this time we have someone who saw it. A girl called Elise Trumbo. About to enter her house an hour ago, witnessed her neighbor being killed. Smart girl. She got out of it, setting off her little camera flash and blinding one of those hoods. Temporarily, worse luck. Anyway, she escaped in her car, and our pals took after her in their Jeep camper. I'm betting that that car was the same one that was stolen down at the beach. Malone, you know that double homicide, too. It was committed with just that M.O. My opinion, there's no doubt about it.
It's obviously the same gang of nutcases we've been after all this time. But there's one important difference. A picture exists now of one of their heads, a portrait.
That's worth leaving your cat for, isn't it?
Come in. Ah, here are the prints back from the lab. Thanks, Mallory.
Oh, no. What a damn disaster. The flash went off too close. Can't use a single one of these.
That's all we needed. I thought it was too good to be true. Wait a minute. In any case, those hoods are sure to try to take out that girl. Robert, from now on, you're going to be right next to Elise Trumbo, and you're going to stick to her like glue.
Where is she now?
At City Hospital. She's still in a state of shock. We left a cop there to keep an eye on her. But she'll be out tomorrow, and you've got to stick with her, even though his honor will howl like a wolf.
Thank you.
stupid shit.
Hey, what's the matter?
You out of your mind?
I said stay away from this. I want you operating. This crap is for weak kids. Little boys who need to work up guts. Guys, it's the system. It does us all in. And that's what we're trying to fight against. It's gonna take blood. And not just anyone's, you know that. Just of the people who don't ever have to work for things, who have it all. Okay, what's the news?
The girl's still there in the hospital.
He's in pretty bad shape, poor guy. We better put him out of his misery. One look at you in the hospital and they'll believe you got a good reason for being there.
Our friend here was hit by a car. I think he's hurt bad. For God's sake, call someone. Come on, move.
Hey, where are you going?
We got a wounded man here, officer.
We got nurses for that.
Now! What the hell is this? What's going on here? What do you want? Hey, you guys, what's going on here? Hey, were you kidding or something? Hey, who are you guys? Are you out of your minds?
Take care of the girl, hurry.
Thank you.
Get away. Go away.
Lady, lady, give me a break with all that noise. It's over. Enough with the tears, okay?
Okay.
You could have taken one of them alive, or am I wrong?
Yeah, you're wrong.
In this particular situation, you had to save the girl. What else could it?
I don't need a lawyer. You're the ones that were wrong by putting only one guard outside the door.
Why was there only one guard?
Because someone at the precinct thought that one was enough. Looks like he wasn't thinking too well.
You know, that's the problem. You're paid to think. And for both of you, that could be a little trying. Now, at this time of night, people are usually sleepy and likely to make more mistakes.
You know, Malone, nobody likes you.
Yeah, I know. Sometimes I don't like myself either, but that's a matter of opinion. And frankly, I couldn't give a damn about yours. All I care about is my work, to finish what I start. And I usually do. Now you asked me to protect this girl. I did. It doesn't matter how I did it. If you still want me to keep an eye on her, she has to move over to my place.
To your bunker is more like it.
That's the way I like it.
Let's see how Miss Trumbull feels about it first.
I just can't take anymore. I don't know what's happening. I'm not in good control. Put me wherever you like. You said bunker just now. Maybe that's the only answer.
Okay, Malone. Have it your way as usual.
You ready to go, miss?
I may be getting an exhibition.
Is what you do all that fascinating, lady?
Well, just making chat. We've been in the car for 20 minutes and you haven't said a thing.
Oh, yeah?
I didn't think you'd be such a grouch.
Okay, so what do you want to talk about? I don't know what to say to you.
Well, I don't really have a one-track mind, and I don't think you do.
Look, I don't know anything about fashion, lady.
I see. All right, don't talk. It's not your duty. And by the way, if you don't want to protect me, I've got an idea. Have someone else called in on the case. Or next time, just let them kill me. That should take care of your little problem.
I think it's about time you close your mouth. Too many stupid things are coming out of it.
places give me the creeps, you know? I better get out of here.
Come on, let's move out. This ain't a healthy place.
Police sergeant and the girl got to be killed. You, go to her house and wait. She'll be back there sooner or later. You might see the cop coming too. He's pretty sure to try to hide her. When you find out where, let us know about it. And no fancy tricks, right?
I need you to do me a favor. I want you to run down to headquarters, pick up the books with the mud shots in them. Bring them over here.
What do you need them for? Seven 30. Sunday, day of rest. All right. One, two, and three.
Hey, mister. Huh? You going somewhere?
Who's that?
It's me, darling. Who else would it be?
Oh, I forgot. I'm so stupid. Listen,
Miriam. We've been introduced.
Miriam.
Oh, what a quick learner. You got it right the first time.
Sweet Miriam. Forgive me. It's awful, but I have to go. I promise I'll be back in a flash. Okay?
I've seen some long flashes in my day. And some flashes in the pan. Mm.
Will you still be here?
In a hiding place.
I'll find it. That's my job.
I'll make it hard on you.
I won't answer that.
Hmm. nobody who looks at all like him.
Thank you, miss. You mind coming down to headquarters with us and help me composite this man?
Of course I will. But on one condition. I'm Elise, not miss, okay?
It's not much, but it's better than nothing. How do you feel today? Any better now that you've rested?
Lots better, thank you.
Good. Come in. Give this to the patrols and to the press.
Where do you get these ideas from? You invent them all by yourself?
Why?
This guy thinks you have a picture of his face. You put this sketch in a newspaper, he'll know you don't have anything. He may never come out of his hole.
Did you hear him? Do as Sergeant Malone says. Quick.
We have something he wants. The bait he's dying to bite.
Grab a bag and pack it with some old clothes and a toothbrush. Only be a short time.
Yeah, that's fine. But I'll come with you. Never know. All right, seems okay.
If you want something to drink while you're waiting, help yourself. My house is yours. There's some great bourbon.
Milk is more my thing.
A man of 1,000 virtues.
Thank you.
Lady's bedroom, sir.
What do you wish your friends, huh? What do you wish your friends? I'll break it off. Tell me, I'll break it off.
No one can tell who that's a picture of.
Nick is dead, but he sure as hell didn't talk.
It was up to me. I should have gone instead. Now it's time to act. It's time, all right.
You have to open your mouth, then do it just to shove in the food I made for you. They're on the table.
we talk for a while? This is brainwash music, it sounds like. I don't know how the kids can listen to that.
Daddy, you're hopeless. Those are the aha.
Aha. I didn't think it was Frank Sinatra.
Gun away, or I'll blow your daughter's head off.
Come on, Barry, get it out.
Out! Our super quiz.
Hello?
Hi,
oh. Derek. I'm Terry.
Terry, what part of the town are you calling us from?
Bronx.
You've been following our program for very long?
The last couple of months.
Is that all?
It's really
Terry from the Bronx. You've been on the air for 11 years, and you're just getting our job. Are you ready to answer the first question?
Hi.
Okay. The house of one of our immortal sports heroes, Babe Ruth, or the Sultan of Swat, as he was called, has a national museum.
That's enough.
Can you tell me what city it's in? Come on, Terry. It's not hard.
I don't think I know.
What are you doing?
You listen to me. You want to see your daughter alive? You get me the photo in Malone, too. Tomorrow morning at the old power station. Tomorrow morning, Walker.
Just try.
And no tricks.
Any city in the U.S.
Or we'll cut up your daughter till she looks like a jigsaw puzzle.
I admire your loyalty, but it doesn't win you our big first prize. We do have a great consolation prize, though. A $20 discount at any Dundee supermarket.
Thanks. Does that mean I go buy something?
At any Dundee supermarket, and $20 will be taken off your bill. That's right.
Oh, geez, that's really great. I shop there all the time.
That's what we like to hear. Now, don't hang up. You've got to talk with our secretary so she can get the prize certificate.
Oh, don't worry. I'm hanging right on.
Great. Thanks for playing our quiz. It's been nice talking to you.
You too, Mel. Thanks a lot.
Okay, and don't forget to keep listening to Mel's Quiz Game every day of the week at this same...
I feel like I'm going crazy. Damned if I can see any way of getting out of this mess. Damned if I can go along with their conditions.
What's your other choice?
I can't ask you to go. You'd just get yourself killed. And I'd spit at myself for the rest of my life. If I were 25 years younger, by God!
If you were 25 years younger, you wouldn't even have a daughter. Look, Max, I've already made up my mind. I'm going.
But you can't. It's just suicide. Don't kill her anyway. Robert, I know why you're doing this for me. But it won't help. I'll just kill you too. So forget it.
I'm not doing it for you. I'm just doing it. I would do it even if it was Santa Claus's daughter.
Get out of here. Let me out. Now!
Come on. Get out. Come on, man. Come on.
Larry!
Not bad for a cop's daughter, huh?
I wouldn't mind tearing off a hunk of that right now.
You can wait till evening. She's a little too upset to enjoy it right now.
Robert never knew his parents. The man in the picture is not his father. He adopted him. He was alone, too. Old and alone. They stuck together, and with all they went through, they found some kind of companionship with each other. Until one day when the walls of Jericho came crashing down. Robert was just a kid then, still in school. One morning, two drunks robbed and killed the old man. Yeah, you heard me. For $7 lousy. Robert survived somehow, but after that, something was different inside him. After he did his stint in Vietnam, where he won every medal in the book, he came back and joined the police force. He's not a bad guy. His battle against crime goes back a long way. Sometimes I think nothing else means a thing to him.
If I could get a bead on him, on that type of man, I'd give a lot to understand him.
What did Walker want this time, Robert? What's so important? I don't like the sound of your silence, pal. Mind if I get something too? Otherwise, I'll just look like I'm going fishing. You gonna give me some cartridges? Or do I use popcorn?
Don't go out. Don't open the door for anyone. Take care of her, Purvis. Is that thing ready?
It's out in the car. Get something to eat. You're losing weight.
Hold her right there. Come one step closer and I'll cut her throat. I mean it. I'm not kidding around.
Listen, pal. This is a .45 automatic. Loaded with lead-plated bullets. A shot at this distance could blow a man's head off. I think I know what's going through your head right now. You're wondering if I got any bullets left. Your guess is as good as mine. Who's got the odds beat? You or me? Today I feel lucky. You want to kill her? Go ahead. You've got the knife in the right position. The sight of blood won't bother me, punk. What you waiting for?
Hey, look, I
don't give a shit. Because I'm going to take one shot just to see how far your goddamn head's going to roll.
That it was a pleasure. It was fun in a strange way, though. I want to say thank you.
You don't have to. Anyway, if ever I get bored, I know where to come for excitement.
Thank you. See you around. Bye.
Emergency situation, 87th and 2nd. Emergency situation, 87th and 2nd. All cars in the vicinity proceed there immediately.
On my way.
A bit of a wait.
I'll be at the bar. Sir, what do you have?
Scotch, double.
Thank you.
not an expert in fashion, but I'm sure you've been quite successful.
Uh-huh. You've been doing a little research, haven't you? I can't believe I'm able to relax, Robert. I actually went and did some work this morning, and it actually turned out okay. I was amazed. Robert. Robert, in this whole business, you know where the biggest surprise came? When you invited me out.
You gotta eat sometimes. Besides, it gives me a chance to get dressed up. But your problems might not be over yet. Wait till you see my face when I get the check.
As long as you don't think you can get away with just one date, Mr. Malone. Next time it's dinner at my place. Do you like Mexican food? Robert? Robert, what's with you?
Nothing. I thought I saw someone I recognized.
Well, anyway, I hate to be forward, but I'd hate even more if I didn't speak up. I think if we managed to have fun even over this last week, we should seriously consider seeing more of each other. Robert, are you listening to me?
Oh, sure, I'm listening. It's just that I never did talk a lot, even when I was a kid. I always preferred action to words.
So I see.
Have a good trip. I like to see you taking a few days of vacation. You have so many that you never took that you could retire right now.
Yeah, I've been wanting to go back there for a long time. Maybe there's still something left at that old gas station.
I hope at least you find your memories.
Stop there, don't move. For my album, nobody will know, okay? When will we see you again?
I don't know. Not too long.
Okay. Bon voyage, police officer.
Goodbye, miss.
One more. Hold it.
Every moment.